Hey, what's up, everybody? Dobby Masters here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to create a comic book effect, which looks a little bit like this. So with this comic book effect, what I've done essentially is we have added in these little black circles, which would look sort of like the pigment or how they printed it back in the day. Then we also have a little bit of posterization of the color, and then some blending and some sort of separation of color here, along with cutting out some frames so that it looks choppy, like, you know, action in a comic book might look. So that is the effect we are creating. It's completely customizable and you can sort of tune it to the style that fits your piece best, but this is the general idea of how I think a comic book effect can be made in Adobe Premiere Pro. So then, let's get started on the tutorial. First things first is we're just gonna start off with a brand new timeline here. And we need to understand that this is a sort of CPU intensive effect. So whenever we're using footage here, we want to make sure we have a proxy. If it's 4K, I have tutorials on that. I can link them in the description below. You'll notice that the bars don't fit here, and that's because this is a 4K piece. So I'm just using a proxy here to make my computer go faster. And once we start adding in the effects, it's gonna slow down anyway. Anywho, this is the effect or the original footage that I have. All I did was I went to Envato Elements, which I have a subscription to. If you want more information on that, you can check the description below. It's a great thing. Thousands of free stock footage once you sign up for the subscription, and you can just sort of search anything and find it. So in this situation, I searched man running, and I got this cool slow motion shot. Now, for what I want to do, I want him to be running just a little bit faster. So I'm going to right click, go to speed duration, and just increase it to double the speed. And then now, he's actually running at a sort of a decent speed here. The first thing that we want to do is we want to add in that checker effect that the other one had. To do that, we need to go into our effects, and we're going to need to use something called checkerboard. Now, if we applied checkerboard directly to this, we would sort of lose control over it, and it would turn this into a checkered board. So what we want to do is we want to go down here into the new item, or you can go up to file, and then new, and we want to just create ourselves a new adjustment layer. A new black video will work as well, depending on what you want to do. So it's going to create one that's set up for whatever the composition is. This is a 4K comp, so it's going to create one for that. Once I drop it on here, I'm going to trim it down to size here, and then now you'll see nothing has changed because that's the adjustment layer. It's just allowing anything on it to pass down. There's nothing on it, so nothing changes. We're going to go to effects. We're going to look for something called checkerboard, like I've been talking about. It's under video effects, generate, and then checkerboard right here. I'm going to drag and drop that onto the adjustment layer, and you'll see that it immediately removes the below one because this is generating. It's taking over the entirety of the production. To fix this, we're going to go down into blending mode, and we're going to go to overlay. Overlay, you'll see that now we can actually see through a bit and the checkered board remains. I also like to change this color to black. It gives it sort of a stronger effect here. You can see that it darkened it a little bit and it made this just a little bit more, a little bit clearer. What's also neat about this is that right off the bat, you'll see any of the white areas, it sort of disappears a little bit, and the darker areas, it comes out a little bit more. And I feel that sort of matches a comic book a little bit better. It sort of gives a little bit of a change throughout it where it isn't all just a single checkerboard over here. We actually have a little bit of dynamic nature here. We're then going to go to the width slider. We're going to change this to width and height, and we just want to make these just a little bit smaller. So instead of 16 by 8, I'm going to go like 11 by maybe 6 here. And you'll see that reduces it maybe a little bit bigger than that. Let's maybe go 14 by 8 or 14 by 7 here. And you just want to play around these with these until you get something that looks a little bit more realistic. I like this. I think that it gives it a sort of a cleaner vibe. However, if you're going for that punchy nature, you can also increase these up a little bit, even larger, and sort of give that sort of punch where the dots are really, really visible. And let's go with that for this iteration of this effect. We'll make them a little bit punchier. So now we have the checkerboard displayed here, and you already notice that your computer will slow down. You won't be able to play this back. It's going to be all choppy and it's going to max out your processor. So from this point on, if you want to view it, you're going to have to click the enter key on your keyboard, and that's going to render this whole thing out, and then you'll actually be able to view it. So let's just finish off this effect right here. We're going to go into checkerboard. We're going to go ahead and I like to create a mask here and just a random mask. And what I'm doing here is, again, I'm adding a little bit of sort of dynamic nature here. I'm going to click invert here, and this is going to sort of create a hole in the checkerboard. And then I'm going to go to feather, and I'm just going to increase the feather a lot. And you can sort of grab this and change it any way you'd like. Draw just a random circle or a random oval, a box, anything you want to do. And the reason I'm doing this is that I am, again, I'm creating just a little bit of a change so that this isn't sort of just put over the entirety of the piece. There's a little bit of a hole here. There's a little bit of a difference here, and there's some difference over here. It just makes it look more realistic. So we have our checkerboard sort of created. When we play this through, it's going to be over, and it's going to look pretty good. Now, I'm going to go ahead and hide this. And when I hide this, it's going to allow me to play the footage back so I can actually look at what I'm doing in the next step. Next step is, I'm going to take this adjustment layer, bring this up a couple of times, and this is going to create some more video tracks down here for me to work with. I'm then going to click on this footage and hold the Alt key and drag up. What that's going to do is it's going to just create a duplicate of this as I go up. Makes it a little bit easier. Before I do that, though, I want to apply an effect to this to give it that punchy vibe. So I'm going to go ahead and undo this, and we're going to go to the effects. We do want to copy, but I'm trying to sort of show you that it's very important the which way you do this. You want to do the effects on this footage before we duplicate it, otherwise we're going to have to apply it to all of them. So we're going to look for an effect called posterize. It's in Video Effects, Stylize, Posterize. We will drop that onto our effect, and you're immediately going to see it sort of creates this, and let's go ahead and hide that adjustment layer again. We're going to see that it creates this sort of banding, and that's because it's reducing the amount of colors that this footage can show. And that's good, because a comic book doesn't print, you know, 12 million colors. It prints the small gamut of colors that it has, and it creates that sort of banding. At least the traditional comic books do. So now we're going to just bring this up to maybe something a little less punchy, maybe like 20. And you'll see we have a little bit of banding in here. Now, turn this back on, and you'll see that we have that sort of comic book look coming into here, where it's a little bit banded, and it's also got those sort of black dots over it. Let's hide this once more, and now we're going to do the duplication step. We have a bunch of our video layers set up. We're going to click on this. We're going to hold Alt and drag up to copy and paste it. We can also click on it and hit Control, or on a Mac, Command C, and then click on this layer right here and hit Command V, and that'll duplicate it as well. What we need is we need three different layers here. We're then going to go over into the Lumetri color. The color workspace is a way to get to it quickly, or you can go to effects, search for Lumetri color, drag it onto your footage, and then go up to effect controls, and the effects will be up there as well. We're going to go into the Lumetri color. We're gonna go down to the curves and open this up. On the very top one, we're going to make this one red, we're going to make the second one green, we're going to make the third one blue. So essentially what we're doing is we're separating out the red, green, and blue so we can manipulate the color channels separately. So in this top one, we're going to go into the green right here, and you'll look, we don't want a plus sign. You can see there's a plus sign there. We want a circle. Going to drag that on down, and then we're going to drag the blue down as well. And now we're going to have a full red. We're going to make this one hide, go to the second one. We're going to drag the red down and the blue down because this is our green one. So now we have green. So you see we have red, we have green, and then this bottom one we need to make blue. So we're going to grab the red, drag that all the way down, grab the blue, drag that all the way down, and now we have, or the green, my bad, drag that all the way down. Now we have our red, our green, and our blue footage. We're going to then click on this top one right here. Make sure you're on the top one. You're going to go to blending mode, and we're going to hit screen. And now you see it's combining the two colors. Here we have the green and the blue creating a yellow. We're then going to go to the second one, and we are going to screen that one as well. And now essentially what's happening is we've rebuilt the original footage. However, we've separated the colors. So it looks exactly like it should, but we now have a red channel, a green channel, and a blue channel. On this red channel, all we're going to do is we're just going to adjust it a tiny bit. Instead of 1920, maybe we'll make it 1900 as the position. And that's going to move over the colors of this red channel just a little bit. Now you can see there's red separation in here. We're then going to go to this one, and we're going to make the position, let's say on this one, 1060, just a little bit. And you'll see that we've started separating the colors of the second channel. And now you can see the split of the reds, the greens, and the blues. We can make this more sort of accented or less. So instead of 19, we can make that 1910. We can bring this one down and maybe make this 1065. And you'll see it'll make it clearer or blurrier, and you basically have control over how separated you want the colors to be. But overall, we now have a sort of a nice effect here where it's like we have color separation throughout the footage, as well as that sort of lower end printing with the banding throughout the footage. We can go ahead and drop this on again, let it load, which will take a second whenever you turn this back on, and you'll see we also have this effect. So overall, we're getting pretty close to our effect being finished. The last thing we need to do is we need to do something called posterize time. So we've posterized the color where we've reduced the amount of color. Now we need to reduce the amount of frames to give it that choppy comic book feel. You can, of course, keep it full frames, keep it smooth motion. That's perfectly fine, but I want to finish it off with that sort of that choppy nature. To do that, we're going to highlight these bottom three, and we're going to recombine them back into a single piece of footage. To do that, we can go into here, and we're going to just look for Nest, give it a name. We can give it any name we want. We could say that this is maybe main footage. And you'll see it's going to create another sequence and put them all here. What this does, creates a single piece of footage that we can apply effects to. We're going to go to time, posterize time, drag and drop it on here, and we're going to reduce this frame rate to maybe about 6. And now it's going to be choppy whenever I play this back. So to get the full effect, we're going to turn this adjustment layer on, which we're going to then see the black dots again, and we're now going to click the enter key on our keyboard, and it is going to render out this red rate here, and we're going to be able to see our final product. This can take a little while. This is very processor intensive, and depending on the speed of your machine is how fast this is going to go. So I'm going to click the enter key right here, and we're going to wait. So our footage is rendered out. It took about 2 minutes for me to render out this 5.5 seconds. So if you're doing this for a large project, definitely set some time for a render in there. We're gonna go ahead and hit that play button, and you can see our footage is playing through right like so. We have that choppy motion, we got the black dots, we have the posterization of the footage, we have the separation of colors. We overall have a nice comic book effect, and we now have the ability to change all of this stuff around. We can change the dots, we can change that little circle right there, we can change how much color is in here, we can separate or bring the colors back together. By double-clicking on this main footage, it'll open it up and you can see these three here again. We have complete control to create a comic book effect. Thanks everyone for joining me. If you have any questions or comments, go ahead and throw them in the comment section below or on our website at adobemasters.net. If you want to see more videos similar to this one, go ahead and that subscribe button. I try to make a video every other day or at least a few a week to help build your knowledge. Thanks, everyone, and until next time, see ya.